Thank you, Radka. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
Yeah, perfect. So as you mentioned, my presentation is about individual behaviors as an indicator for the attributes and the health of dairy cows. I'm coming from the Faculty of Veterinary Medicine, Skopje, Macedonia. And this presentation will be, I hope I will be on time. Please stop me if I'm going too much over time. So regarding the individual behaviors and behavior in general, it's the main point is that sometimes some of the behaviors are actually a result from the some of the inputs that are the animal is affected to. So as a result of these inputs, the animal will behave somehow in with certain behavior. And this is also the case with the sickness behavior, where if the animal is challenged with some of the infections or inflammation in the organism, then there will be some changes in the behavior. So we all know about the clinical manifestation like fever, anorexia, fatigue, sleep, mood changes, and so on. And there are some of the mechanisms that are more or less explained, like the cytokines that are affecting the hypothalamus and the other mechanisms that actually are affecting the behavior. But what is the long-term impact if the animal, any disease, that does this disease will affect the long-term behavior of that animal? And here we could not find so much studies about this. On the other side, we are all aware about the attributes of the animal, like the age, the body condition score, or the production of the animal, that also could affect on the animal behavior. So so Sarova and the others are also confirmed that the age is having an impact on the social rank in the herd, that the nervous cows are producing less milk, or we all aware about the estrus behavior, or prepartum maternal behavior, or if, as we saw in the previous presentation about cow-calf bond and different behaviors in that context. Also, which is quite interesting, is the spatial distribution. So in the available space where the animals are moving, they, depending on the resources, depending on their attributes and preferences, actually you can see and the distribution in the space is different. So the objective of this study was to identify the existing associations between the attributes of the animal, the medical history of the animal, with the individual behavior of dairy cows, including their spatial distribution in loose housing system. For that purpose, we observed 91 lactating cows in a commercial farm with a free stall system with more than 300 animals. And in this scheme, all the animals were enclosed in this area with the red rectangle. And these 91 cows, we observed it with the cameras placed it in these red dots. So this is how the observation was going on. Well, and this is the camera view for the observation. So as I said, we observed 91 cows for two consecutive days from 7 a.m. till 9 p.m., meaning 28 hours of observation. We identify each cow based on their color and marks. And of the skin, and so in total we have an individual continuous observation of more than 2,500 hours of video materials. So while we're observing them, the different behaviors we recorded by using the Boris software for that, and we observed all these behaviors defined in the ethogram, starting with different states of the animal, like lying, standing, moving, feeding, social interactions, but as well as the usage of brush or scratching and other behaviors. Regarding the attributes, we used the application software, the data update that the farm was having, and we observed the age of the animal, the production level, the medical history with different diseases and sickness during the lifetime of the animals. in order to understand the spatial distribution in this enclosed area, we divided the space in 8 different zones. 4 of them were the zones in the feeding alley, in the feed where the feed banks are, and 4 and the other 4 were at the lying area of this enclosed area. After clearing and refining the recorded the variables after the observation, in total we collect we have 47 different behaviors or dependent variables that we used in the further analysis. In the data statistic, but besides the descriptive and standard statistical analysis for attributes and for behavior variables, we introduced several criteria for understanding which of the zones were preferred or favorable by the animals, and these were based on the time that the animal was spending in certain zone, the time when the animals were spending for feeding or staying at the feed banks or lying, or any agonistic interaction per each zone in the enclosed area. For analyzing and finding the association of different behaviors versus attributes of the animal, we used so-called a triangular approach. So we used 3 different types of statistical analysis in order to find any association. First, we used the Spearman-Crank correlation, then we used a cluster analysis, non-hierarchical k-mean clustering, where the 18 groups of different behaviors were crossed with 20 attributes, so we have more than 360 cluster analysis, and based on the parameters for the cluster analysis, we classify the presence or absence of of any association between the attributes and behavior of the animals. Then at the third statistical analysis was the PCA or principal component analysis, where we use the attributes as active variables and behaviors as supplementary variables. So in total we use 6 in this case, particular case we use 6 principal components where that explains 77% of the variance of the collected data. And then we cross all these 3 analyses in order to classify and categorize, is there a present of any association. So if all 3 analyses don't show any association between the attributes and the behavior of the animal, so we clarify that there is no association. If there are opposite results, that means not conclusive. But if some of the analysis or all the analysis are representing, are indicating some association, then we classify as partial or as a present positive or negative association. So in the results, like in total from the mean individual observation per cow was 11.5 hours, ranging with a quite range, of course, and 80% of the time the cows were lying or being at the feed banks. Standing duration during the observation was 1.5 hour, and 80 minutes of total was moving during this this observation per day. Regarding the favorable preferred zones, so this is the enclosed area, but colored with different zones are colored like that. Those that are with green, they are most preferred zone, and those that are in red are least preferred zones from the animal. So as you can see in general, that the preferred zone in this area, in this enclosed area, were the mid zones. The exception here is ZR4, as you can see here, it's in the right corner, but that's because of the mineral or salt cubicles that were present here. So even here, the agonistic interactions were much higher in this place when you compare it with all of them. Well, I don't have time to explain it in more details, but we can discuss later about it. Regarding the association between the behaviors and the attributes, the first analysis, the correlation, we found 70 significant correlations between attributes and behavior. The most, I would emphasize, the most higher one, like for the negative, were that the lame animals and the older animals were receiving less displaced, when you compare it with the other. And also the time spent at the feed bank was negatively correlated with the age. With the positive correlation, we found that the animals that are having a history with high somatic cell counts in their life, they are receiving more chase. They were more chased from the other animal individuals. The usage of brush was positively correlated with the body condition score, and the standing duration, standing time, was also high for the older animals, or positively correlated. In the cluster analysis, I will not show everything, but these are only examples. You can see from here that animals with lean cows or with low score or body condition score has the lowest value of lying time. So they are lying less when you compare it with the other animals. And this is that cluster on the right graph here with the centroid on the completely on the left downside, that which indicates that exactly what I've said. For the other example, classical example, is standing time and the age. So you can see that the youngest animal were having a lowest value of standing time during the observation, while the older animals were having the longest time for standing duration. And these are the clusters of the animals, these extremes ones from on the left and on the right side of the graph. So in total, with the cluster analysis, we developed a cluster summary matrix, which explaining we found total association of 79 associations between the attribute and the behaviors, and 30 of them were partly, and 49 were significant association. The last analysis was the PCA, and here you can see the principal components that are quite associative. The standing time is associated with age and with the medical history, which is not the case with the feeding time, and brush duration were related with pregnancy and body condition score. So in total, when we summarize all three analyses together, we have signed for each of the associations between the behavior and the attributes. So from 760 relations that we analyzed, we found 25 a positive and negative association, 160 partly positive and negative, and two were inconclusive. So to summarize, we can say that the older animals are standing longer and less time they are in the feeding bank. They are lying in the most preferred zones, but they are trying to avoid conflict, so they are not in the heat of social conflicts. They are not in that zones. Animals with mastitis and with history of mastitis and somatic cell counts have a partially positive association with the lying time, so they are positively related with that. Lame animals are positively related with the standing duration, standing time, and negatively with the feeding time. The animals, they have a lameness in the current lactation, were partially negative with the feed banks, and they were avoiding the preferred zones in the enclosed area. So that spatial distribution here could be used as a potential indicator. And pregnant animals were standing longer and lying less in the lie and moving less, especially in the last part of their pregnancy stage. Also, they were avoiding social conflicts, and they were in the less preferred zones in the enclosed area. And also, leaking and other behavior like mounting was found in the non-pregnant cows, which is quite related with the potential estrus stage. At the end, I would like just to emphasize the perspectives of this approach. So this is only developing a hypothesis method to define hypothesis for future research, but this approach could be used as testing and establishing housing standard, monitoring for the farm management, even for disease diagnostic and sampling, which animals we could sample for medical testing, and as well as for the potential indicators for animal welfare assessment. And yet, I would like to thank you for your attention, and thanks to all the organizations, institutions, and people that helped me in this.